How might the sharp micro principles of microeconomics student think about cost for our professor?
He's also losing $60,000 a year in salary.
Okay, in what way? You're right. I agree with you.
Well, it's just like, well, because he's choosing to go manage, so he's basically a $60,000 opportunity cost of managing.
Awesome, awesome. I love that word, right? Opportunity cost. There's an opportunity cost associated with it. So if we start to factor in the opportunity cost, how would you restate the profit equation? How would the econ student, i.e. that's you for the next test, calculate profits? Well, the 400 hasn't changed, so we got no problems there. We know the 360's got to stick, right? So then it boils down to, how do we handle this 60? Is that on top of the 35, or is it in lieu of the 35? Jake, what are you thinking?
Subtracted.
Do you want to subtract it from this 5?
No,
so essentially count this and the 60, or just the 60, or... Just the 60, right? So we won't want to double dip. That doesn't seem quite right on calculating the opportunity cost. So 400 minus 360 minus 60 gives us what? Negative 20. Okay, so when we think about profits, there's a number of different ways to do it. Now, what's going to happen when the IRS, if you calculated your tax return and you say, hey, I lost $20,000, and you claim a loss as a tax write-off equal to 20, how's the IRS going to look at that? Does that sound fair? Are they going to allow that loss to be deducted?
No.
Right? So you can see that this would be subject to some issues here. Well, I'm worth $200,000, and so I had a loss, and so I don't owe any taxes, right? We could kind of play with the numbers quite a bit. So that's not going to stand with the IRS. This would stand for the IRS. And at the end of the day, this is what the professor goes to Walmart with, right? So my point with all this is that none of these calculations of profit are wrong. None of these are wrong. Some are better than others, i.e. this one, but we'll get to that in a little bit.